Now this may be old news to many of you, but it came as a surprise to me. You know, Brave browser, one of the most secure popular browser that people like to use, they aren't exactly privacy centric anymore, or at least they didn't seem to be privacy centric because of a recent scandal they were involved in. If you're a Brave user like me, you would know that they are heavily invested in crypto, right? They are constantly promoting crypto deals to you, they are constantly promoting different kind of wallets and stuff like that. So it's very apparent that they're invested in crypto. But did you know that every time you visited a crypto website, they are actually including their own affiliate codes into your website? Even until a few months ago, they were auto-populating some affiliate codes in the URLs that you were typing, like for example Binance. So it seemed like you are visiting from their affiliation, so they would earn commission. Now that is fine, if you are voluntarily willing to support Brave, then that was okay, but the thing is, they never made it available to the public. This was not public knowledge. Users like me or anyone else probably had no idea about this, and they were profiteering out of it. And all this on top of them being privacy-centric and bashing Chrome, saying that yeah, Chrome was cool in 2013, Brave is the next new thing. I mean, is this what you're doing? I mean, Chrome is no better, they are stealing your data openly and they admit that. But you are doing the same. I mean, you are profiteering off of your users, but you are not making it clear to them. I mean, there are many privacy-centric open source browsers out there, like Firefox, for instance. They rely completely on your donations. People can openly donate to them and support these projects, like Tor Project or even DuckDuckGo, for example. These are all great examples of privacy-centric apps. But none of them are doing something like this, right? They never did a automatic affiliation inclusion with the URLs that you are visiting on your own. And yes, while that doesn't really affect you in a negative sense, it's still not cool that they went behind their users' back. You know, this reminds me of the incident that happened several years ago with Pirate Bay, you know, the popular torrents website. Now people had this impression that these pirates are your friends, you know, they are taking this valuable thing from companies and they are giving to people for free. Well, that's not the case at all. You see, Pirate Bay was caught several years ago installing crypto miners on your PCs when you visit their website. So they were actually using your PC hardware to mine crypto. Do you still think they are your friends? They are using your computer's hardware to mine crypto for their pockets. And when they are caught, their official statement was they were exploring other means of monetization. Really? So that made it very clear to me and to many other people that they are not your friends. They are just thieves trying to make a profit. If they can profit out of you, they will. So stop promoting them and stop supporting them. This would have been far less of a big deal if they had openly come out and said that, hey, you are our users, we need your support. And I'm sure there would be hundreds of thousands of people ready to support them. And in fact, the CEO had to come out publicly and apologize with a rather long Twitter thread. I'll leave a link in the description if you want to find out more details. And yes, it is a pretty old news which has been resolved since then. But as an advocate to online privacy myself, I am not so happy about that. The reason why I'm reporting this now is to tell you that don't just take everything at face value. At least now we know that when a privacy-centric company is heavily affiliated around crypto, it's not necessarily a good thing right off the bat. But anyway, those were just my quick thoughts about a rather old news which I recently realized and I was a little alarmed as a Brave user. I mean, do I suggest you uninstall Brave altogether? Am I gonna do it? No, I'm gonna continue to use Brave, but I'll be a lot more mindful of what I use and I'll be switching back to Firefox as my primary default browser. I mean, I use Firefox for all my desktop activities anyway. I'm gonna be doing the same on my mobile phone too. If you'd like to see more of these online privacy related videos, let me know in the comments. We'll make more of these. Of course, you can join more discussions like this from our Discord. Link is in the description. I'll see you there.